Hello Buddy, how are you doing? Welcome to my channel. Today I'm so excited because I'm gonna make squid croquettes. Like this video. For this recipe we are gonna obviously use squid. Right of Marino, you can support the channel if you want. Okay, we are not gonna start with the squid. We are gonna start with the vegetables. We are gonna start with the onions. I'm gonna sweat the onions. I'm gonna finish chopping the tomato and the green pepper. I'm so excited! Ah! I'm gonna add half pepper. Doesn't need to be diced or and one tomato. It's a little bit destroyed this tomato. Poor guy. Now I have all the vegetables in here. They are all sweet. I'm gonna put a little bit of salt and we are gonna prep the squid now. Time for the squid ink. It took me a while to reach these things in Dublin. So now it's time for these guys. I love squid, reminds me of my country a lot. And this sauce especially. I'm actually going to use two for this recipe and I'm gonna set aside one after it's cooked because I'm gonna have it for dinner. So yes, easy to clean. It's a little bit messy as well because of the ice. It's easy, you just see here, this kind of plastic, but this is the spine. You take this out, right? The head with the tentacles, something like this. We'll separate this part. Look at me. This part of the eye. And take this part out. So when you have it like this, without the spine and without all these things, you wash it up a little bit and you turn it this inside out. So this is how it looks like after being clean. Tentacles and the body. And we are gonna add them to the pot. Oh, this is gonna be lovely. Put the lid on. Cook them at slow heat until they tender. They soft. Can't wait. By the way, this recipe is not gonna be the actual typical croquettes. I'm gonna make like kind of fluid croquettes. I'm gonna add gelatin on it. Let's see how it works. I've never done this recipe before. I hope it's gonna work out. Change my top because I had a little bit of eye from a squid. Life. Welcome back. Squids are nearly done, so we are gonna keep going in the process. I'm gonna separate the sauce to add to the bechamel we are gonna make now. We're gonna blend the sauce. Properly seasoned, actually good. So we are gonna chop the squid. Chop the squid, put the sauce aside. Now we have to make the bechamel. We are gonna make not very thick bechamel because we are gonna make the bechamel with the gelatin, so it will go liquid. So first of all, rehydrate the gelatin seeds in cold water, always cold water. Next, we are gonna make the roux, go to the stove and melt it. When it's melted, we add the flour. In the end, milk, if you can warm it up, it's better because it's gonna prevent to get lumpy bechamel sauce. I'm gonna use 250 milliliters, so I will use 30 grams of butter and flour. The butter already melted, so I'm gonna add in one time the flour. I have my milk warm. I'm gonna add it in three times just to prevent the lumpiness on it. Another induction thing, induction cooker. So let me know if you want me to cook beside this chopping board instead of being turning around. Let me know what you think about my new setup. I'm gonna add one third, add the other third, and the end. Yeah. Very good bechamel, always season it. We add the squid ink. Now add the squid. And cook it through. Let the ingredients meet each other. We're gonna cook it for 7 minutes, more or less, 8 minutes. I like 7 minutes, so maybe 7 minutes. Need to boil. Cook it through. Our gelatin seeds. Remember, this is only gonna melt on into a hot sauce, into a hot liquid. That's why you rehydrate it in a cold one. In the meantime, while the squid is cooking with the bechamel, we are gonna prepare our chili to cool it down. Just need a little bit of olive oil, cover it, and that's it. And be ready with a little bit of cling film. We are ready with our bechamel. I hope it will work. It's kind of a little bit very liquid, but I believe the gelatin will work on it. Finished for today. I'm gonna cover this with this cling film. I'm gonna eat this spoon. And I'm gonna keep this overnight in the fridge. Love this flavor. Love. Let me know if you like it. Comment me down below. The color, what do you reckon? What do you think about the color? I don't know. Like, I like the color, but because I'm grow with these things. It's very typical from Basque Country to make this. This is gorgeous. Make a few holes for the steam. Hey! So, welcome back. Our croquettes has been in the fridge for a night, and we are gonna now proceed to bread, pane, whatever you say. I use panko, and we are gonna make double breaded or pane or whatever you say. I don't know, double, because I think that the bechamel is too liquid, and we don't wanna struggle. We'll beat the eggs. Panko is like the Japanese breadcrumbs. So here we have our bechamel. It's been setting for 12 hours in the fridge. Yeah. And it's gonna be just fine. We take about a spoon or so, make the shape, whatever shape you want. Okay. So now, croquettes in here, let's soak them all in the egg to let them drain properly here.
And now they come back to the breadcrumbs, panko in this case.
Yeah! Now we are gonna deep fry them. We're gonna proceed to deep fry our croquettes. Bit of color. Not very high heat, but not very low either, because otherwise they get soaked in the oil and you don't want this. Here we have our squid in croquettes.
Yes! The liquid inside.
I really, really hope you enjoyed this recipe. Try this out, because it's really worth it. Takes time. You kind of have to cook a little bit. But it's very, very, very tasty.